Hi guys, it's October here. I thought I would share our trees. First of all, I'm going to show you downstairs. This is the tree that's in the living room. And I finished it tonight because I was in town and busy and stuff. So this is what it looks like. So I've got white bobbles. I've got black bows. Black bobbles. Sparkly silver. Bubbles, got white roses, black stag, more white roses, got white icicles, mini stockings, and black sparkly bubbles. More roses, black stag, that's from my son, and you can see the white stag through the branches there, and the pièce de résistance, tree topper, batty dude, had to be done. So I'll give you a quick show you around the other side. I've got white icicles, pewter bauble, black baubles, another white sparkly rose, sparkly silver bauble, another bay leaf, and this is one I like. Bit dark actually to do this, but this is my Wilco's witchy bauble. I've basically done some runes and some writing on it. You can't really see it that clearly. Kind of can. Anyway, so that. Another stag dude. These actually are black corded lights because I decided to go for the black corded lights because I didn't want, you know, the tree to be black and then the cord to be green. Pretty much speaks for itself, really. So anyway, so this is my tree, black. Get the gist of it. So that's my tree anyway, so yay! This is my updated Morrigan fireplace altar. It's quite basic. It was a lot busier at Samhain. I've kept it basic. I was in town today and I picked up three of these kind of cool, I don't know what kind of style you'd call them, gothic-y sort of style frames. So I put one on the side, one on the other side, and the other one I've got over on my new Morrigan working altar, which I'll show you in a minute. So basically, this represents, it's got the dark and the light, because it's obviously going from the dark side of this time of year, and slowly going into the lighter side. That's why it's got the dark. The black and the red, and also the colours black, red and white resonate for me, as most people will know by now, for Morrigan. So this is on the God side. Everybody's probably seen them before, it's my little holder. Again, on the side I've got a light candle for when we go into the lighter half of the year. I was going to put a black one in, but decided to put a black one on the Goddess side. And I've got my, you can't really see that, but it's my candle that I had in Samhain, so I'm still burning those down. Decided to keep them where they were. I've got my little snowflake mini candle votive. It's got all of its sparklies. I think you can see that. And I've got quite big, large pillar. It was two big, large pillars, these, £4 or £5 from Asda Walmart. And we've got these today from Tiger. I just like the imagery on it, and it casts lovely light. So again, I decided to put this on. And typical beginner claims decided to go overhead. These I got from Tiger as well, £1 each. Now, to me, obviously they're icicles like snowflakes, but to me they also have a slight air of sun imagery about them. So I have one on this side, my offering bowl, Celtic offering bowl, which probably most people have seen already by now. And then I have another one, same, on the goddess side. And then I've got my Blessed Yule picture that I made for Witchcrafting, which originally was on my other Morganella, but I decided to move it and show you what I've got there instead. Same on this side. Obviously alternate colours. Red on this side, black on this side. Again, same thing, sparkly, and a snowflakey sort of holder. Again, big pillar candle from Asda Walmart. But on this side I have, again, the same gothic-y sort of style picture frame. Again, got this out of Poundland, which is £3 for £1. And I found this lovely piece of art online, and I decided that it just had to go on my Yule altar, really. For personal reasons, I just loved it, and it's got a little bit, you can't really see it, but there's little bits of snow on the branches and stuff, so I love it. A little spiral doobie-da thing. Same on this side, except we've got the black motif. And I'll show you a few other bits. Okay, this is my updated Morgan Rocking altar for Yule. Oh my god, goddess candles. I've got my triple raven doobie-da. I've got my little spiral again. And I've got my Celtic Cross candle holder, and my lovely Morgan Heart by Damiana. I have, these are pretty much illuminator candles, but the colours again mean something to me. So I've got two white pillars, and they are from Asda Walmart, same as the ones on the other altar. And we've got little spell chimey candles on either side of the same picture that was on the other altar, again to represent the rebirth of the sun. So we've got red on this side, incense, and again, we've seen this already, my alternate black and white candles, which I'm burning to take us all the way through to you. So basically that's that. I'll show you a couple of other bits, then I'll go upstairs and show you Anna's tree. This is my sparkly mosaic black heart that I got from B&M's a week or so ago. And I took the sort of Hessian sort of string off it and used the sort of cord, the black and white cord that was tied around one of the packs of baubles. Got my sort of like arty party tree, so that's up there. And then I changed the ribbon on this to the black and silver snowflake ribbon to hang my little doobie-da on, my little raveny dude. Again, he's been up since I went and is going to be staying. I have got snowflakes because I want to focus. Where's the other one? Other snowflake. These were from Poundland. And then the other snowflake, again from Poundland, three in a pack, different sizes. Then we have got my snowflake garland, again from Poundland. So they're quite cool. I'll try and do this quickly because if Ali wants in here, he's not going to want me hanging around in here. It sees red hangy garland. His theme is red and gold. So I've got that from Asda Walmart for a pound. This one, gold, again Asda Walmart for a pound. And the piece de resistance for Ali. This is Ali's tree. We didn't have a star, so we had to do a makeshift job. So if I had this star and a pack of three like tied together, so I basically just took the strange kind of string off it and just got a red ribbon, put it through there, and he had a star. So he's got red lights. He's got all his jewel colours, got red baubles, gold baubles, gold icicles, sparkly red baubles, other icicles, red heart bauble. Is it? He's got chocolates, more different kinds of baubles, red and gold sort of stringy angels hair stuff, that stuff. So this is Ali's tree. He's got some reindeers, but I can't really see them that well. I'll show you the ones that are hanging up elsewhere so you get a better idea what they look like. So this is basically Ali's tree and he likes it very much. So there we go, Ali's tree. That was the reindeer I was telling you about. Sparkly red reindeer. He's got them dotted about his tree, but you can see better what it looks like. So like that. We also have this red sparkly ribbon and gold sparkly ribbon. So we're going to do something with that yet, but we don't know what yet. So that's the last thing to do in here, and he is all set for Christmas. So that's about it. So hope you guys enjoyed. Lots of love and blessed be. Bye.